Welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds, Blind. Ooh, my god. It's always tough when it starts up for some reason. Still walking around the outskirts of Edgewater, seeing what there is to see. Ooh, dissenters in our midst. The enemy seeks to destroy our way of life. Well, we can't have that, can we? Die, robots. Ludwig Miller, a guard watching over the landing pads south of Edgewater, see last episode, is convinced that auto-mechanicals are planning to wipe out humanity. He's asked you to help him wage a secret war against the mechanical menace. Ludwig reports that he spotted a forward scout of the mechanical army north of the landing pad. As a test of your mettle, he's requested that you dispose of this scout in the name of humanity. Alright. Did I get his gravesite fee? Because he just said he would pay up if the guy joined the resistance. I don't know if Silas wanted to do that. I'm getting kind of stuttering going on here. Some heavy ammo. Thank you very much. And more. And light armor. Light ammo as well. Oops. Is this where the robot is? Okay, there's a bunch of stuff around here. A dead assistant. Ethology log. Pterorays? I don't know. Mating habits? Kane von Acker, Spacer's Choice Ethologist, assigned to Terra 2. This week I've decided to study Pterorays mating habits. I don't know if I'm saying that right. The female Pterorays leave their nesting area in the morning and return in the afternoon with random objects, typically something shiny or bright. Then they build displays with these objects and perform what I can only describe as a dance for an audience of males. If a male likes what he sees, the two go off and nest together in one of the nearby trees. Gerald, if you're reading this, I'm done waiting for you. Collect my things and meet me at the next site. And don't be late. I expect punctuality from my assistants. This is not... Gerald. Oops. Is this alive? This thing is alive, isn't it? Yeah, it's a living one. Weapon parts. Spacers what? Spacers chaw? A tin of spacers chaw, recommended by 10 out of 10 medical professionals. Chaw. What is chaw? It's like chewing tobacco or something. Do I dare? Canid and Feral. Oh my. These are the Pterorays. Oh, crap. Pterorays beak. And wing. The arm and wing membrane of a pterorays. Pterorays wings are not recommended for eating, chewing, or licking. In fact, just to be safe, don't do that to any part of a pterorays, okay? Yeah, I didn't realize... There's nothing else coming for me? Sometimes I hear a strange noise. Yeah, that was kind of crazy. Canid skull fin. The bone protrusion from the top of a canid skull. Due to its unusual shape and colorfulness, this bony skull piece is used as adornments on bookshelves and mantles and makes for rather decorative bookends. I need more ammo. Well, oh god, her leg was chewed off. I wonder if I'll run into this Gerald and I can let him know what happened. That was rather crazy. Pterorays beak, the pointy mouth part of a pterorays. Ground into a powder, boiled in water, then mixed with tobacco and starch. Pterorays beak becomes a food additive with a gelatinous consistency, often used as a binding agent for processed meats such as nuggets, borscht, etc. Well then. Damaged mechanical sentry. Is this the thing I have to kill? Ooh. Deal with the mechanical scout. Done. Energy cell, joint actuator, flywheel, and armor parts. A movement mechanism from a limb of an automechanical. This small electrical motor allows an automechanical to move a single joint in one of its limbs. It requires an external power source to operate. Flywheel. A small metal device used to store rotational energy. Fun science fact. Have you ever wondered why it is hard to push over a functioning automechanical, but is it easy to tip over a non-functional one? This device is the reason. And armor parts. A collection of hardened fibers, metal plates, zippers, buttons, durable threading, belts, elbow pads, knee pads, shoulder pads, and leather patches. The average contents of a tailor's trash can. And yeah, I realize I'm out of ammo. I didn't mean to hit that. Can I end that? I can end it. Okay. Well, cool. Alright. So this is the flywheel. Turn. Joint actuator. So this is a beak. It's like it's made out of plastic. Combat drone. 8 bits. Some heavy and light ammo, good. Still not enough for now. Cool, some more assorted ammo. Frozen dinner. Yummy. A light pistol. Another Nico pad. I can't get over the name of some of this stuff. Tarmac and cheese. More sliced bread. Without the age, bread. Well, something we picked up was new, wasn't it? Frozen dinner, yeah. Made in a variety of types, the most popular is fried chicken, mashed spectrum potatoes, and spiced mock apples, although the Borst loaf dinner is a close number two in all respects. It's not the best dinner. It's Spacer's Choice frozen dinner. Fried chicken, mashed spectrum potatoes, and spiced mock apples. Oh, this because it's spectrum potatoes of different colors. Featuring signature sauce, all-in-one bestseller. Intriguing. Combat drone pieces. Toss ball card. Kyle Redu. A collectible toss ball card. Redu is known for his deft coverage of the Wednesday Zone. Huh. What's up? That one's empty. Well, there he is. Tile brand. First edition toss ball series, 10 subjects. Sweet. Junkyard. And they say one of these people is at the junkyard. You heroically thrash the mechanical scout, preventing vital intel from falling into the hands of its metallic masters. Ludwig will be pleased. Barbershop, cannery, and a residence. Town leader, this way, but behind all this stuff. Nice. How's our ammo now? Better? Still not the best, though. And you can go through that amount of ammo really quickly. Not getting in there until I get a 3 mag picks. A cigarette lighter. Well used, most of the lighter fluid is gone. This unadorned cigarette lighter is straightforward to use. Well, it would be if you had lighter fluid. Not recommended for use in Byzantium. Good cartridge. Oh, there's marauders over there. I don't want to deal with them until I get more ammo. They hang out pretty close to the city or town limits, whatever you want to call it. Pretty bold of them. So I'm not jumping up on that. Go poking through the trash. Oh, like it's condensed into... Remember trash compactors? Like personal trash compactors? I remember my parents had one way back in the day. I don't think they sell those anymore, do they? Here's these weird things that... Like... I don't know, they're building? They're either currently building it, or it's... The ruins of something that once was there. Nice. More Adreno. I'm still looking around the outskirts of this place. Kidding me, all this stuff here? Let me go peek through here. Okay, now we're on the other side of it. Jeez. Sprats? Sprat hide? The skin of an entire adult sprat. Did you know that sprats are found in every human colony world? Did you care? Not really. Actually, it's pretty interesting. Well, who knew? There'd be things inside these areas to kill or something. Sell my junk. Bloop. So maybe I'll hold on to one light pistol in case one breaks. Let's have a light assault rifles. Light machine gun. Maybe I should be using the machine gun then. Sawed-off shotgun. Wait, what am I using? Light assault rifle. Pistol. Oh, I wasn't in buy. I was in buy, not saw. Gotta be. Yeah. Yeah, I'll sell this. So I'm keeping one light pistol, at least. An extra. Wait, does that mean I have three of them? I do have three of them. Alright, so I'm selling one. No, I'm in buy. I hate when I do that. There we go. Sell. What do we buy? $60 heavy ammo for $38. Buy, oh, 300. No. So it's 6 per round? You realize how quickly these things add up? Never mind, I'll find it myself. Pep pills. That sounds like a Fallout item if I ever heard it. Pep pills? The pick-me-up pill! Companion ability cooldown, minus 50%. 15 seconds. If you need to stay alert, Spacer's Choice will give you a perk. Voted number one drug in the colony among Spacer's Choice made caffeine-based speed-altering products. More sprat hide. Ooh. Can I hack this? What is this? Ooh, nice. Edgewater Saltuna Cannery. A Spacer's Choice property. Terminal access. Spacer's Choice Saltuna Marketing Division. Unlock second story balcony door. Personal files, messages, and exit. Balcony unlock. Sweet. Messages. To R. Thompson. Oh, he's the leader of the place. From L. Gibbs Marketing Division. Subject, excellent news. Hey boss, just wanted to check up on the new Saltuna Light project. I've been brainstorming some new taglines for the product line, and I think some of them will really catch our customers' attention. Sweet. From R. Thompson. Dear Lawrence, I appreciate your hard work on behalf of our beloved brand of Saltuna. I've just received a response from corporate. They're not interested in your idea of a light version of the Saltuna brand because we'd rather not compete with ourselves. But they are interested in the idea of lighter Saltuna. Effective immediately, we have been instructed to use heavier weighted cans so we can pack them with less Saltuna, thereby saving bits to every can. What? Oh, God. I love this kind of stuff, though. This is exactly the kind of breakthrough our cannery needs. In fact, our logistics department has just confirmed my request to have you transferred from the marketing division to the cannery. Can you imagine, Lawrence? You'll be rubbing elbows with your fellow workers on the canning line, filling each slightly heavier can with slightly less Saltuna, hour after hour, day after day. This is a great and tremendous honor for you and for me. Somehow, I don't think Lawrence will be happy about it. Effective immediately, your position in our marketing division has been terminated. I expect you to report to our foreman tomorrow morning. Your uniform will be deducted from your pay. Welcome! Oh my God. Poor guy. Like, I quit. Personal files. Ideas for Saltuna Light taglines. Melts on your fork, not in your mouth. Less fat with some Saltuna flavor. It's brine time! Now with the satisfying crunch of cartilage. You can't spell Sultuna without salt. It's true. Note, also can't spell Sultuna with ants. Potential to market towards families? Leading scientists say it's still food. The Sultuna will thank you. Warning, may cause auditory hallucinations. We'll add more later. Alright. That was very entertaining. Ambidextrin? What's ambidextrin? Dehydrated water tablets. Water without the hydrogen or oxygen. Last 30 seconds. Just add air. Now available and carbonated. Ambidextrin. Nasal stimulant. Bonus critical damage plus 15%. Or for sniper. Bonus to extra headshot weak spot. Damage plus 25%. Shoot in your snoot. Okay. Interesting. I'm sneaking just in case there's more of those things. So far, so good. Is that the thing we unlocked? Balcony door? Skin tough salve? Chance, yes. Yeah. I have some of that already. Ooh! I could jump across to there. I think you really enjoy this game. Bolter pistol. Ooh. Jotch? Jock? This small, lightweight pistol will make you feel like a big shot. Who can fire a big shot? Three more Adrenos. This pistol fires bursts of plasma bolts at the enemy. The weapon is lightweight and uses E-cells that are quickly drained by the burst fire. Sweet. I love the look of this thing. Freaking awesome. It's like, it's got a Western-style holster. You know, like the OK Corral and everything. And it's kind of like got that old metallic look, but yet... You know, once you get past the holster, then you're into... Like, what I want to say, steampunk type of look. I like it. So I do have energy. I have some energy. I could maybe use that. 8 bits. I love this. Freaking awesome. Do I have to sprint and jump? Sweet. This is a take. 20 bits. And some ammo. Oh, I can't go in there? That'd be even cooler if I could go in there and then work my way down, but nope. I know I can't get in there, but I just have to click it. I have to. Evicted! Do we need more mag... mag picks, right? Is that what they're called? I'm gonna sneak, because stuff happens. Can't get in here anyway. Oh, what about back there? If I drop down there, am I gonna be able to get out? Ow. I guess if I had managed to land there, it wouldn't be as bad. Cool, a mag pick. Another light assault rifle. More ammo. It was worth it. Now if I like can actually leave. More heavy ammo. No, we could just jump here. Alright, hold on a second. I got an itch. That won't reach. I wonder if I should mess with those marauders. Still prefer to have more ammo than that. Ooh. Well, that was weird. I restarted. So all these people have been evicted. Oh. There's a bunch of them.